Welcome to FACTORIO Reverse Megabase. My name is Nita, so this is episode 3 of our Let's Play. And I can't believe we are at episode 3 and there's already so much done. Well, I had to do some things between sessions because the next thing we want to do is actually try to figure out how we're going to do some of these things. I do think that I want to have like the main one, the white, the space signs upwards, because that's more space up there. There's more sort of up and out and stuff. And then on the diagonals, we'll have the small ones. So that's going to be red and green, or maybe green and red. Either way, what I have done is try to lay some foundations. Well, actually not foundations, but actually some locations here, and just trying to gauge how it would look like. So what I've done is like taking 40 chunks and then make another hexagon. Not 40 chunks, make another hexagon. If I made 40 chunks up here, then it would be a square, and I don't think that's quite the right thing. I'd want it to be a more of a fractal pattern, so if we, when you zoom out, it looks like that. So I did this. The blinky things is because of the trains, and I did not deliberately make that. So basically that's that's my tentative idea, and I do realize now that once I've built all the signs, it's going to look like a chaos symbol, but yeah, it's going to be anything but chaos. So Zinch is not going to be happy on this one. Right, so something I highlighted or just started to talk a bit about before on the previous episode was that maybe I'll just make a little roundabout here. And since they are going to be so driving so rarely, I think that's actually okay. The only thing is just how far up do I want it? Dirt, indeed, dirt. Yeah, so that's going to be the first thing, and then we'll see if we can... Yes, do we want it to be this tight? Maybe. And then kind of just around that one. Oh yeah, I have to enable this one again. Here. Yeah. They'll probably start flying out with the stuff out there. Yeah, they did. And that means here. Does that correspond? Oops. That one's just outside. Yep. And that one's just outside. Yep, that's good. And it should be possible. It's not at all possible because that one's going to be in the way. Goodbye. There. Oops. Last one out. Okay, so let's see. We're going to get... This will be outbound, so it'll actually come from this location and go outbound this way. And I'm quite set, oops, on this location. There. And this one will go in here. It comes in and goes into that location. That looks good. I mean, does it though? I don't know. That one is coming inbound, so this will be heading this way. Okay, and from this one, it actually looks rather symmetric, surprisingly, or maybe not. And this is the outbound. Yep, so it's going to be a little curl here. Dirt. Again, we will have at maximum of 6 trains. So I really, even though we're going to do high throughput or so, yeah, high throughput, it's not going to be, it's going to be really big batch sizes. This looks remarkably good, I think. Huh. Surprisingly good, I might even add. That one here. Oops. There. The power poles here are not something that's actually going to, that's actually not particularly important. And I know that it might seem like it, but it actually isn't. What I'm just doing is I have a consistent grid where I can, and then I'll replace it with whatever I need, wherever I need it. So for example, I mean, I'll take the grid here, but the fact that it's out of sync here just doesn't matter. Does it? Or does it? We don't know. Yeah, and then that one. And on the other side, probably also something like this. Oops. Come on. two, and then it connects both sides. Perfect. I'm going to have the fourth one in just for symmetry, but nothing is there until we have the eighth signs. All right. So the next thing we want to do is, oh yeah, we are kind of moving a bit too fast, kind of having a few too many robots, but that was a lot of construction out here, and I think I'm going to keep it so that we can move around a bit better. Right. So what I want to do is I want to make sure that the entire inner circle here is one gigantic block. Well, no, not really. These are different blocks, but still. So only at this point does it actually unlock. There goes out. That's where it opens up for the other thing. Anything in here, it's just going to be belts, that one, and that one's inbound. Oops. Inbound, and oh, I don't need to go in here. I can just do that one. That's going to go outbound, so that's the only place we'll have a signal. That one's blinking. Why the hell are you blinking? Because it doesn't block anything as long as the other thing is also. Yeah, okay. So that actually doesn't matter. It doesn't matter at all. Not one bit. I'm not going to do output signals because they don't matter again. That one, that one, that one. This one is inbound. Exception is that one is outbound. Yep. I'm going to do this one inbound. And this is then when I'm going to get there, 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 and there. It might be a bit a bad idea to have this one because there might be some tempted to go back. No, we don't want to have that. And this one should not be able to go out unless it can go all the way out in one go. That means this one is stuck until it is free to go out here, here, here. So this one will be going up. So basically at this point, and we're going to just make signals. I have a feeling that these three were added here because of all of my Let's Plays where I activate them from a debug menu. I have this feeling, which is a nice feeling. Makes it all warm and fuzzy. Yeah, so you can see here all the ones that are blue, they're basically just, yeah, this is all one block-ish. So they can either be in here in the station or they can be waiting out here. That means if I get a second train, it's going to stay out here and wait. So that's actually super simple. I think the one we want to start on, and I think it's a good enough location to start it up now, is that I am going to start running out here. Actually, maybe I should have a second train so that I can ride this train out. Ah, that's actually a good idea. So I'm going to get another train here. One, two. Nope. There. And then we're going to take those magical boxes. One, two, three, four, something. Oh yeah, that's kind of not. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, maybe? I have no idea. But we can do it by doing this and then see if it's, oh, 20. So not even close. It did feel like a lot. One, two, three, four. Push, push, and then try again. Copy that one. Yeah, 16. And all I need is that one. Look at that. Magical boxes here. Only thing we don't have is actually some fuel. Oh, that's an infinite fuel. Ha, huh, interesting. It's, what is it? Why? I don't know what that is. Bigger than terawatts. Petawatts? Bigger than petawatts. Okay, it's a lot. Yeah, that's actually a good question. How are we going to do fuel at this point? I think for now we are just going to do it by request a chest. Yeah, that one, nuclear. Three. Boom, boom. Copy, paste, paste. Should be good. This one's all good. I'll take 3 plus. There we go. That I have 6. Oops, and I need 6 more. 1, 2, 9, 10, 11, 12. Yep, I'll go up here to the other. Oh. There. All right, that's good. And I'll do. I'm also going to need some trained or some. Yeah. This one will go in. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Stations do not have reasonable names. Huh. Okay, now we can actually. I can actually do limits on this stop. And that would not be a great idea. That would be a bad idea because that means it will be stuck at the previous station. Yep. So we could use the new things. We're going to start by taking an icon there. And then we're going to get. I have to go to my Twitch chat myself. Go back to my Twitch channel and do my command called arrow. Arrow. There, and then copy the arrow. That is just, yeah. If you want those arrows, they are part of sort of, I don't know, is it called Unicode? I don't know what it is. And we're gonna get there. Ta-da! Except it's the wrong one, but never mind. It was a good start. This one is now green. And this one will now be changed as well. I like that there's a little 2 up there, so we can see that there are 2 stations with them. Now you can see that 1 is about number of stops with this name. Excellent. All right. So I can take this one. And you really want to go to this one until empty, I guess. Yay, we have a train automation. Woohoo! Awesome. And... I built it on the wrong track. Okay, I don't want to get it anywhere else, so I'll just cheat it over to the other one. All right. You're going to just sneak over there, and no one will be any the wiser. Actually, I need you to go way back. Because I need the whole train to be available there. Do we think that's possible? Yeah. There, now it's on the right track. It'll get into that one. Oops, don't get run over by the train. That would be so embarrassing in this kind of setting. Oh, that was perfectly fit. All right, so what we're seeing now is this one is ready to go in at this location. There's 200. Oh yeah, that's. I don't want to use circuits if we can't help it. That unfortunately means that there's going to be 2,000 of those. And I am going to set you to outbound. So we'll just see. This one will be stuck here because it can't go in there yet. And only now will it be able to go in. Because it reserves the entire path out. And only then. It actually doesn't take very long to get that out. And yeah, jump out. Switch to manual mode. Because manual mode, we can actually drive. All right, so what our next objective will be replacing this magical train with a normal train and then actually having it build the stuff in the magical train. If we drive at a certain speed, it will be able to go fast enough. Faster, faster. Because every time we stop, it's going to be a bit of a... Oh, almost. Yeah, this is almost... It's incredibly close to disaster, which is exactly where I like to be. So I have not really figured out how we want to do the red circuits or red signs yet. So what I expect to be doing now is just trying some different things. Okay, how far are we? More than halfway. Great. So basically we have 2 different options on how to do this. And that will be... Either we build it directly into the train, which I kind of like, and I think we want to try to do that just to see how that pans out. And there. All right, so we have different options. One option is making a build. That would be a build that looks, I don't know why I had to build. Okay. So the idea here is here. There. So my one option is make stuff in here. Yes. And red circuit. Yep. And just pour it in here. Yeah. The disadvantage of this is the time that it takes to get out, and before it comes back again, these ones will be stuck. But more likely, what is actually way more important is to try to figure out if we build something like this. There, that's good. How fast can it fill up a train? Because that's going to be the bigger issue here. Because we had previously calculated that it would take 42 minutes, or we'd need to run it on a 42 minute cycle here. So if I do this idea, build this directly in here, then we need to figure out sort of the calculation. If we just do that one, we're going to go by minutes. It's going to get 8,400 per minute. Oh. And this one can take 2,000, 4,000, 8,000. So just, is that really true that one of these can create 8,000 per minute? That's not true. 8.4 per minute. Oh, I'm an idiot. I thought there was, yeah, okay. Yes, I was going all Danish nomenclature with thousand separators. All right, so what we are obviously, and this is where the fun stuff starts, we are obviously going to need a lot of modules and beacons. Oh yeah, they're already here. Modules. Let's see if we can do some kind of design here that is seven wide. If we do something that's seven wide, and if you can see here, this is seven wide, it's going to be 3 plus 3 plus 1, that's seven. If it's seven wide, then it fits to the size of a train plus the spot in between. So if we could do something like this and just try and see again. Okay. Now again, how much are we going to make per minute? And I'm going to need a calculator for this as well. I need to have 8,000 in 42 minutes. That means I need 190 per minute. Huh. That's not working, is it? That's not even close to enough. Hmm. Let's take these out. We'll just do this now and get some power. That one and that one. 190 per minute. 184. It's not enough. Yeah, so one of my big concerns with this is if this is not even enough on the red one, if we look at the crafting speed of all of these, then you can basically see that red is crafting every 5 seconds. Then already by the time we get this one, we're going to have issues, right? That one is 2 every 10 seconds. So that's 1 every 5. So that's okay. This is the worst one, by far the worst one. And we're going to have to figure out a different solution to that, but we'll get that. We'll cross that bridge when we get there. These are just also very, very awful. It does seem like I have to put in 2 more modules here and then to be able to fully supply enough. Maybe that's okay. Maybe that's not okay. Hmm. Kind of, okay. Okay, so this actually is a good point where I don't want that one and in here. Yeah, so I'm moving too fast otherwise. But now that I'm doing design work, I'm going to take this one out here. Good. And there. So something like this is actually better. This is enough, 100. If we do change this to green just for a precaution, then just to see how much that would be, that would not be enough. What about if we made that's a lot of beacons. 94 times 2 is 190. 94.5 times 2. That's 189 per minute times 48 2 minutes. That's not a full blob here. So, yeah. So what I think is actually the case here is that this setup isn't really, I mean, this is still going to be there, but the fact that I want to feed this in directly is a super good idea. It's just not a feasible idea because there's no way I can get 12 beacons on this one because that one is exactly not hitting. So I can only get 10 beacons on one of these. You can theoretically get 12, but then you can't do the setup where you put everything into one. Then you can do another setup though, and that's kind of where we are. Also, we haven't even started discussing how that would actually get stuff in here, because this one needs beacons as well. Gears as well. Gears need to be built, and I think I want to make gears directly. Maybe I don't know. Yeah. So this is one option. But it's not really a good enough option. So I can't really see how. I also expect, by the way, to be building this in a different way. So I think that my trains, if I actually wanted this, I should have made the trains like longer. But I like the 416, and we're not going to change 416 trains. We're going to take this one. And maybe we'll just say, you know what? There may be other designs coming later for other things, but for now, this is the design we're using for this one. Like that, and like that. So how would I get, in case of this one, what do we need? We need 81 per minute, or per second, 1.3. That's not much. I want to limit the amount of assemblers here. So what the benefit of this one is, that it can load quickly here and it can easily load into that one, and then we can have a small buffer here of 200. So that's great. So when it comes in, it can actually start loading the stuff that's here because it has to work pretty much all the time. Now in this case, the speed of this one, I'm going to go back, we're talking about now per second, because we're talking about sort of inserter speeds not going to be a problem at all. What I think we can actually do is make a separate build that makes if we take this design 1.35 times 16 wagons, that's 21. That's half a belt. Basically, is this really true? I can take a belt of, really? This just seems, how did this one go so high? Oh yeah, it's because that one. Yeah, okay. So even now it's gonna get even more pronounced. Yeah, that one per second, 1.225, yes, times 16 wagons, that's 19.6. That means actually we are in a position where a single belt would be enough. A single belt, crazy, right? That goes out, and then we can just go like that. And then, I don't know, performance-wise, and this is maybe something someone can help us with, are these worse or equally good or anything with regards to performance? So the advantage of this one is that I have two different inserters for two different materials. That means they're not going to ever get stuck somehow. And this one is easily enough. So that's actually pretty simple, this part. I like it. The only thing we need is just figure out how big, like this one is super repeatable. Well, almost like that, super repeatable, like that, as I said. And take that out, and one more, and then I'm just gonna check if that, yeah, that links over. Cool. So this one is good. All we need at this point is just a production of iron and copper coming in. So we basically need a copper train and an iron train coming in, but these will not actually be very quick. Let me just check this one again. So we're talking about 1.225. Actually, I think I'm gonna do some, we're gonna make one of these and just write down the numbers, because that's the only thing that works. All right, we're talking about per second. Yeah, per second, it's a big build, so we can do talk about per second. Calculate 1.715 times 16 wagons, that's 27 point something. I'm gonna mark that as 20. That's for one side. 102 per second times 2, there, 54, that one, 55. This is how much is being crafted, and in order to supply this, I'm going to need 225, there. I'm going to need this one, minus 39, minus because it's being consumed, this one, minus 39. Oops. Here we go. Great, taking a screenshot. And on this one, I'll, in order to make 39, technically 39.2, I'm going to divide it by the productivity and multiply by 2. That means I need minus 56. If I take, and I'll just, that would might have been just skipping ahead a bit too fast. This one. Oh, I need to get used to this way of doing it. I think it's good, but I just need to get used to it. All right, so here we're using Magic Calculator as always. And actually it would be lovely if you were not constrained here. So it basically says you produce 1.4 and it, oh, it's the crafting speed 1.5. Ah, okay, that's why. So for 1.4, you get 2 inbound. Yep, so that's correct. So if we get 56 inbound, we divide it by 2 because each craft takes 2, and then we multiply by 1.4. Boom, 39.2. That's exactly what we want. So we need to figure out if this one is fully modulated, how much is it going to get? How much can you make at a full module speed thing? That one, this, yeah. There, all right, now we do that one. You can make 22, so I just need 2 of these. But actually less. It's definitely the two assemblers, but the question is if this is enough. 30, no. So it does look like we actually have to and this part, 44. Okay. I'm just again trying to get the numbers right. 41. 37, okay. And the part is here. I just need to get one iron lane in here. Basically, if we want to be really strict about it, I can take an iron lane in here, and I can take an iron lane in here. Take that one up. This will be fine. This will be fine. And I'm gonna put two outbounds and two outbounds. And basically, that's all we need to feed all of this. And I don't like not having it symmetrical, so I'm gonna make it symmetrical no matter. There. 41. What if? Let me just check something. And no, it's still, no matter how much I try it, it has to be 40. 41 is the, oops. And there. Okay, so we have some building blocks now. Basically, we need a train in that can deliver 56 iron per second. That's not even two belts. And we need another one, a copper belt that can provide us with 39. So that's one belt. So basically, all we need to do to get all of this up and running is, I need to open my inventory. It's basically have So in even numbers, this is what we need, right? This is all we need in order to feed this. And, oh, did I not make a mistake? This one was making 41, and that's what I need for all of it. So actually maybe I should do it in a different way. What if this one, but pretending that this is the last train going in here. And how many beacons do you need? You need 11 beacons. All right. That's six. And nope, not that one. Are there. 20. Perfect. So I'm going to get my iron in here. I'm going to get this part out here. There goes inbound, inbound, outbound, outbound. And obviously I'm gonna need some structure here. And basically if I do, that one, getting half a build in on the inside, and this one, one belt in. It has to be more than half a belt. That's it, right? That's okay. Oh, something is not working. And I'm just gonna go up here and make sure that we consume everything so that we can just see that it's flowing. All I wanna see is if the inserters are fast enough. Nope, they're not. If we wanna be really cheeky, then we do that kind of inserter, because that forces this inserter to grab from the outer belt. And I think actually if I do that, then this should be actually enough. Let's see. Okay, it's input shortage. All right. Not a problem. Always working. Perfect. Yeah, so all we need is now this build here. This build is easy, this build is easy. And it's gonna take some scaling up though. And all I need is now to make sure that, so basically this is going to be way overbuilt. But you know what? That's we've done some good calculations. We now know the numbers we need. We need to make like one of these little nests, and that goes into all of this crap up here. There's also an argument about why would they be on the outside here, here. Oh, I think this is excellent. I know that it's not going to work for the green science, but it's damn close. But at least it works for the red science. And then we also, to make sure that this playthrough is going to be have some variants, then maybe some of them will be belt based, maybe some will be train to train, maybe some will be robot to train. But this one is going to be like this, because there's no reason not to do it like this, as far as I can tell. Anyway, I think this is a good place to end. We've come up with a design. What we need to do now is figure out how it connects to all of this, and then we can take this train in, and then we can replace it, send it back, and all we then need to do is figure out a way to get iron and copper smelting in here. And that's kind of the big other part of this. One thing is just getting this train in, but we also need to figure out how do we manage our iron and copper trains in this base. Are they going to be equally big? Are they also going to be 416? It seems to me that that would probably be the right size. And then we have the question of how are we doing dedicated locations, dedicated smelting, or remote smelting? I don't know either, but we'll figure that out as well. Anyway, it's going to be enough for now, at least. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you're enjoying this weird and somewhat different design let's play. Anyway, thanks for watching, and as always, stay effective.